Good evening. I feel that there are two challenges that I face now. We are running behind schedule, so it is about 9 o'clock, and we are left with very little time against 1.5 hours, actually, which we should have got. So the second challenge is that there are so many eminent speakers who have come on the dais from the evening that the first session started, and have almost covered all topics and mostly raised questions which would have actually required time equivalent to a day. It could have been converted into a seminar rather than a debate. So we have to just now quickly get our thoughts together as to how do we reach, because most of the time spent so far has been on what are the problems, I mean, and how do we go there and get it done. So what I would request is that all the panelists, eminent panelists who are on the dais, to kind of share their own thoughts in terms of how do we sort out what was said by various people in the last 2.5 hours. And I would like to start with Mr. Shri Devasthale as to how he can discuss the role of infrastructure, which almost every speaker from morning has kind of, I mean from evening, has kind of touched upon, and present your own thoughts on that. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Nagre, and good evening, everybody. I guess we have 3 minutes.
You have 5 minutes.
Thank you. Everybody today talked about infrastructure. And we have been discussing this subject for last so many years. A lot has been done post the liberalization process. We started public-private partnership program of Government of India. Today we see a number of projects being developed by private sector, airports, ports, roads, some water supply schemes. So lots of things are being done. But in spite of that, we have issues. If you travel in Mumbai, as Mr. Sinha, Yashwant Sinha mentioned, that he was delayed because of infrastructure in Mumbai. And if you travel in the suburbs of Mumbai on weekends, it is almost impossible to drive a car. So while a lot has been done, there are so many issues, so many problems which are remaining. I just have 4 thoughts as to what is required to be done. Maharashtra, of course, is a very progressive state, highest in many areas in terms of attracting direct and foreign direct investment, so on and so forth. But having said that, these problems are not only for Maharashtra, they are for the entire country. And what I am suggesting is something like a 4-point agenda. The first point is, as Mr. Anand Mahindra mentioned, we need a vision. If you are talking of infrastructure, it is not possible for us to build infrastructure without visionary leadership. We have seen in countries like Hong Kong, with very limited space, fantastic infrastructure has been built. But I think that requires tremendous amount of planning. That also requires complete, total planning. So I think the first point, what I'm saying is, we need a visionary approach in the state of Maharashtra. And along with that, there needs to be tremendous amount of long-term planning. If you go to United States, the kind of infrastructure which was built some 50 years ago, it was real visionary kind of work which was done by the then rulers. So I think we need that, and for that, it will be useful and important for the government of Maharashtra to involve private sector right from the stage of planning. That is the first point, that is visionary leadership and involvement of private sector from the planning stage. The second important point is the reforms which are lagging behind. If you look at acquisition of land, most of the problems in the infrastructure space are because of non-availability of front or land. And the land reforms plus the reforms relating to real estate are extremely important for us to go forward. And there are so many other things which are required to be done, but I think because of paucity of time, I'm not dealing in details. But this is the second important area which I think we need to look at. The third thing which is neglected, and I think one of the most important aspects, is we don't have skilled workforce. And I'm not talking about engineering talent. I am talking about skilled workmen. there is a tremendous shortage of welders, plumbers, electricians, and there is a mass movement required for ensuring that we build quality infrastructure, and for that we have this force available with us, and this cannot be done by the government alone. I think it's important that private sector takes lead in this, and there is a government there. Again, we need a visionary approach in terms of building the skill sets throughout the country for building the infrastructure. The other important point, I think, which is extremely relevant today, it is not enough for the government to be honest. Honesty is given. When you talk of government, I think governance is given. And therefore, its integrity and honesty has to be there. Otherwise, there is no government or governance, according to me. But I think that cannot be the only qualification. Along with that, we need competence and efficiency. We have seen many projects in the infrastructure sector. There are delays. And I think it is essential that the government takes the role of, or the chief ministers take the roles of chief executives of private sector. And I think the kind of accountability which is there in private sector has to come over there as to why are these projects getting delayed. So I think we need efficiency in delivery and also competence in management. Both these things are relevant in addition to honesty. I think funding is the last issue which we have got. There are lots of things which are required to be done in the space of funding. The government and the Reserve Bank of India is seized of the issue. We need depth in the corporate bond market, and I think today that is one of the problems which the country is facing while implementing. We don't have a long-term corporate bond market. There are not enough number of investors, issuers, investors and market makers, and all these three elements are required for building infrastructure. So I think to summarize, a lot has been done, but number of things required to be done, and finally, a visionary approach.